From the OUTV Broadcast Center in Los Angeles, California, this is Brief News Brief, a brief look at today's trending news topics. Proudly combating the thought police since 2016, here's your host, James Heaney.
I'm James Heaney, and this is your Brief News Briefing. Rocket Man, Trump has got a nickname for Kim Jong-un. Rocket Man. Today, President Trump addressed the UN National Assembly for the first time ever. And you know what? It was unprecedented. You wouldn't have expected to see what he did up there. He threatened to totally destroy North Korea. He also coined a brand new nickname for Kim Jong-un. It's Rocket Man. It's fantastic. First, it debuted as a tweet, but then he brought it to the real world stage and said it right there in the National Assembly. Rocket Man. Kim Jong-un is being called Rocket Man. Skid the flop. Trump loves to use nicknames. We know that. We elected him. We know. Everybody knows he used to be one of the outsiders. He's Pony Boy, and he was told to stay golden, and that's what he's doing. He's staying golden up there. Now, I'm not sure if the UN appreciated it as much, but at least we know he's being authentic to himself, right? He also signaled that he might put the kibosh on the Iran nuclear deal, which is kind of weird because it seems to be working pretty good. In fact, maybe we could use something similar in North Korea so that we don't have to worry about nuclear bombs. Just saying, I'm just a regular old normal Joe, okay? Trump expressed a lot of good versus evil lines. It felt apocalyptic for confrontation on the world stage. It seems like with these hurricanes and earthquakes, it's not looking as good as I'd like it to be. And his speech was downright bizarre. It had religious language in it. It made me feel like it was the end of days. In July, Paul Manafort's home was raided early one morning. And back in July, Brief News Brief was on the report. But at the time, we had very little details. Well, it turns out we learned more today, because more details have been revealed. It turns out federal agents with a search warrant picked his lock on the front door. Now, there's not many reasons to pick a lock. Most of the time, they'll just knock on the door and say, hey, it's the FBI. You may or may not have known we were coming. But they'll pick the door if they think they're going to a person's house for when they knock. And the person's like, who is it? Oh, it's us, the FBI. They think that this person's going to immediately destroy evidence so fast that you wouldn't be able to kick down a door. And if I know one thing about the FBI, it's they can kick a door down like that. All right. But nonetheless, the FBI, with the search warrant, raided his Virginia home. They took binders of stuff, documents, and copied computer files. They were looking for evidence. Afterwards, Mueller issued Manafort a warning that they planned to indict him. And CNN reports that U.S. investigators wiretapped Manafort before and after the election. The Graham-Cassidy healthcare bill is getting crammed through Congress. This is Republicans' last-ditch repeal to Obamacare. They campaigned on it for 7 years, and this is their last and final chance. I feel like I've been hearing it's the last and final chance. What makes it so special, this Graham Cassidy and the Sun-Kissed Kid presidency? Why is this the last chance? Well, turns out, Senate rules repeal legislation can only be passed by a simple majority until the end of September. After that, they need a supermajority, 60 votes. The CBO, which scores the bill on a cost effect for American people, will not have the time to score this bill before the vote. So senators will be voting on a bill which they do not know how much it costs and how many people will be kicked off of health care. But do they care? Nuh-uh. On the anniversary of its deadly 1985 earthquake, Mexico City was rocked today by a 7.1 magnitude earthquake. It damaged buildings, knocked out power, and caused alarm throughout the capital. There's reports of fire and gas leaks and people possibly trapped in rubble in the Mexican capital. There's also reports of at least 7 people dead. That number's going to grow. It's probably already outdated. That was what I saw earlier. There was a less deadly 3.0 earthquake in Los Angeles yesterday. I felt it. I was right here. At first, I was on my beanbag chair, and there was a little bit of rumbling. I was like, is my dog itching herself next to my head on the beanbag chair? But then I looked over, and I noticed all of my guitars were swaying on the wall. A 3.0 is nothing But it's definitely something that woke me up last night. Not woke me up, I was awake. But it woke me up to this sleep that I didn't need to get renter's insurance. Wow, I am rambling. But it's scary. I felt it in Los Angeles. We are bracing ourselves for the big one that's eventually going to hit Los Angeles. It's inevitable. Will I be here? I don't know. But it's scary. Hurricane Maria. A Category 5 hurricane devastates Dominica and Guadalupe, and it's hurling itself towards Puerto Rico. It's expected to make landfall early tomorrow morning. No generation has seen a hurricane like this since San Felipe II in 1928. That's what Puerto Rico Governor Ricardo Rosello said. He also said, "This is an unprecedented atmospheric system." Why are we seeing so many unprecedented storms? Harvey, we've never seen a storm like that. Irma, a Category 5 hurricane hitting Miami. That's unbelievably one of the largest hurricanes in the Atlantic in history. And now we have this, the largest one we've seen since 1928 in this location. This is all happening at once. I don't get it. What could possibly be happening in the world? What could be causing all these hurricanes? I haven't the slightest idea. I wish that scientists would help us out. Maybe somebody smart could be like, well, if you stop doing something or take care of something, maybe. Oh, well, I've got to go get my Hummer out of the garage.